Hi everyone, and welcome to our channel. In this episode, we're going to take a closer look on how you can create components from within the Aspire software by Vectric. We're going to be using version 11 for this video. On the Modeling tab of your software, you have multiple ways to create components. One of them is simply to create shapes from closed vectors. In that options, there are several different profiles that you can use. A domed shape, a pyramid-shaped or angular profile. There is a concave profile and a smooth profile. There is the flat profile and a new one called a sweep, which is a custom vector profile. There is the opportunity to adjust the base height, as well as adjusting the final height to no limit, limit to a certain height, scale to an exact height, blend to inner vectors, and of course the new sweep option. There's also tilt if you'd like to adjust that as well. So let's take a look at how some of these look when you actually apply the profiles or shapes to closed vectors. We're going to start with a star, a simple closed vector that we've created, and we'll click on the dome shape to create the profile. It's going to be set to no limit, and we hit apply. And you can see the end result. It's a domed shaped star. We can adjust the height of the profile as a positive or a negative. We could also, as I've said, adjust the base height. If you choose the limit to height option, you can see the end result is that the domed shape starts out from the modeling plane and then ends based upon the dimension that you enter. It flattens out. The next up would be the pyramid shape or angular profile. Choosing that option and clicking the No Limit radio button, you can see the end result is more like a pyramid. Of course, the higher it goes, the more deformed it goes. If you limit the height, it will again, much like the dome shape, start at the modeling plane and raise up until it reaches the number or the dimension that you've put in and then flatten out. Clicking on the concave option produces a star that has a slight slope to it. Starts off smooth and rises up to the point of the star. Again, adjusting the base height or limiting it to a certain height. So, there are multiple options you have at your fingertips. The smooth option simply does that. It creates a smooth star. And of course, using the limit to height just does that. It will stop it based upon the dimensions that you've entered in. The next one is what I call the plate. It's simply a flat shape. There is no shape height to adjust. Simply adjusting the base height will increase its thickness. All of the other options have been grayed out. The last option within the create shapes is the sweep. Choosing that icon, choosing the sweep icon, you select your vector, choose the profile that you would like to sweep around the inside of the star, and you can create some interesting effects. Changing the base height will adjust it as well as the shape height. Of course, you can use any open vector shape for the profile, for the sweep. It lends itself to be very creative. There is an additional option within the create shape that we did not look at. and that's simply to blend to the inner vector. I'm going to take my star and offset it inward, creating a second star. Selecting both of those vectors, I go back to my modeling tab and create shape icon and choose the blend to inner vector. Choosing my domed shape, you can see how the resulting component starts off as a dome and gently blends to a flat area. The next option is the pyramid shape, or angular shape. Again, it starts off smooth and stops and flattens out. The blend to inner vector is available to be used on all of the options within the shape profiles. Concave creates a smooth rise of the component. The rounded shape is, again, just rounded, as its name implies. The flat plate is simply that, just a flat plate where you can adjust the base height. And the sweep will take the profile that we've created and sweep it between those two vectors. Interesting stuff. It allows you to be more creative than ever before. Using the blend to inner vector also allows us to use other shapes. We're not limited to just the original star shape. We can choose, for example, a circle. I've created my new vector of a circle, chose my dome shape with both the star and the circle selected, blend to the inner vector, and hit apply. And the end result is the component has now a circular flat area. Changing the base height or the shape height will make that flat area more pronounced. And you could do the same with the pyramid and other options within the Create Shape. The nice thing about this is that the circle doesn't have to be directly in the center of the star. Here you can see I've offset it to the bottom and created the new component. I think it looks rather attractive and could be used as a first place prize with an actual ribbon attached to it. You can carve someone's name or the event or something special onto that circle area. I'd like to think that there are a few ways of doing something. I also like to keep exploring on how things could be twisted and tweaked just a little bit to make my designs, and maybe yours, slightly different. It's a simple approach of just being slightly different. Not to be better, but just different, giving the clients and the customers something else to look at. Not everyone's going to like them, and not everyone's going to appreciate them. But that's okay. There's something out there for everybody. So if you know me at all, you know part of my philosophy is three answers to every question. So I took the star, and I thought, I wonder how many different tools I can use to create a shape similar to each one. So I'll use the first star, and I'm going to use the sweep option that we saw earlier, and I have my profile and hit apply. And this is the end result. So I thought to myself, well, can I use any other tools to create the same thing? Or am I limited to just this one option? Let's take a look. I chose my second star. I'm going to choose to offset it inward by 1 inch. I chose the 1 inch simply because that's the width of my profile. I'm checking to see where the start nodes are of each of the stars, and I'm going to use my two rail sweep. We've seen in previous lessons that to make sharp, consistent corners, it's best to place that profile at each point. You can see where the profile has a start node, in a sense, the red square, that will be attached to the red vector, the outer vector of the star. So we hit apply, and that's option number two. So is there a third way of doing this? Let's see. I'll choose my third star and offset it by a half of an inch. If I choose that new vector and I choose the extrude and weave and my profile, and hit apply, in this case, you'll see it's backwards. Not to worry, all I need to do is hover over my inner vector and reverse the direction, and now they're all consistent. So, three different ways to produce the same product. If you'd like to get rid of that solid plate that's in star number one, here's one of the ways you can do it. Simply by choosing the first star, clicking on the properties, and lowering the base height down so that the plate, the inner area, is below the surface. See, it's a slightly different faded color. That indicates that it's below. I'll bake it, close this out, and choose the Replace Below option within the software. And that will delete that light shaded area, which is below the modeling plane. Now we have three stars, three different ways. Which is the best? I don't know. It's up to you to decide. Which is easier, and which is faster, and which is more convenient for you. So, I hope that you've learned a little bit more about what can be done with the software. If you need some more help, look at some of my other tutorials. I have some rather interesting ones in the past. If you're just getting started with 3D modeling, I recommend that you take a look at my 3D Modeling for Newbies series. I'll leave a link in the description below. I think you'll find it very interesting and hopefully helpful. If you have any suggestions on topics, send me an email. I'll be glad to see if I can develop a video for you. If you'd like to learn more about the software, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to click on the bell to be reminded of our new videos. And of course, as always, if you need help, send me an email, mm@mozolic.com. I'll be glad to help. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Enjoy.